Hello and welcome to our short video on how to design a dual supply discrete programmable gain amplifier circuit. This schematic represents a dual supply discrete programmable gain amplifier circuit. The circuit changes the non-inverting gain of the amplifier by varying the gain setting resistor R1. To easily change the gain of the circuit, R1 is often chosen to be a digital potentiometer. Even though the gain of this circuit varies, which typically changes the cutoff frequency, the circuit is designed to have the same cutoff frequency for all gains. This video explains how to design this circuit using TI's OPA364 in a few easy steps. The input for this circuit ranges from negative 1.25 volts to positive 1.25 volts. The output swings from negative 2.4 volts to positive 2.4 volts. The design uses dual 2.5 volt supplies, and the gain varies from 6 dB, or 2 volts per volt, to 60 dB, or 1000 volts per volt. The equation for VO is the transfer function of the circuit. The input signal, VI, is amplified by the non-inverting gain, which is 1 plus R2 divided by R1 plus R3. Notice that by using a variable resistor for R1, we are able to change the gain of the circuit. The first design step is to calculate resistors R2 and R3 to set the maximum gain when R1 approaches 0 ohms. The maximum gain, Gmax, is equal to R2 divided by R3 plus 1. Rearranging this equation to solve for R2, we get Gmax minus 1 multiplied by R3. By selecting R3 as 100 ohms, we calculate R2 as 99 kiloohms. Since 99 kiloohms is not a standard value, we will use 100 kiloohms as shown in the schematic. The next step is to calculate the maximum R1 resistance to set the minimum gain, Gmin. The minimum gain is equal to R2 divided by the maximum resistance of R1, which is Rmax, plus R3 plus 1. Rearranging the equation to solve for R1 max, we get R2 divided by Gmin minus 1 minus R3. Plugging in Gmin and R3 into the equation, we calculate a maximum R1 resistance of 99.9 kiloohms. Since 99.9 kiloohms is not a standard value, we will use 100 kiloohms instead, as shown in the schematic. Next, we need to calculate the feedback capacitor to set the cutoff frequency, FC. To keep the cutoff frequency constant for all gains, we will first calculate the cutoff frequency at the maximum gain using the gain bandwidth product of the amplifier. We will then use that cutoff frequency to calculate C1. The cutoff frequency is equal to the gain bandwidth product of the amplifier divided by the maximum gain, Gmax. We calculate a cutoff frequency of 7 kHz. Using the cutoff frequency we just calculated, we can now calculate C1 using the equation 1 divided by 2 times pi times R2 times F sub C. We calculate a capacitance of 227 picofarads. Since 227 picofarads is not a standard value, we will use the next closest value of 220 picofarads, as shown in the schematic. The last step is to check for stability at the minimum gain, since this is the most likely gain to have stability issues. The minimum gain occurs with R1 set to 100 kiloohms. To ensure stability, the circuit bandwidth, FC, must be less than the zero frequency, F0, created by the resistive feedback network and the total input capacitance of the op amp. F0 is equal to 1 divided by 2 times pi times CCM plus CDIF times the parallel combination of R2 and R1. CCM is the common mode input capacitance of the op amp, and CDIF is the differential input capacitance of the op amp. F0 is calculated to be 637 kHz. Since the circuit bandwidth is less than the zero frequency, the circuit is stable. Running an AC sweep analysis for multiple values of R1 we find that the gain varies from 6 dB to 60 dB. Also, notice that the cutoff frequency of the circuit remains constant for all gains. This verifies functionality of the circuit. When designing a discrete programmable gain amplifier circuit, there are a few design notes to be aware of. First, R3 sets the maximum gain when R1 approaches 0 ohms. Next, stability should be evaluated across the selected gain range. The minimum gain setting will likely be most sensitive to stability issues. Finally, choose a digital potentiometer, such as the TPL0102 for R1, to design a low-cost digital programmable gain amplifier. Texas Instruments has many online resources to help you design circuits with op amps. This includes reference designs and guides, educational videos, simulation and prototyping tools, support resources, and search tools. Thank you for taking the time to watch this short presentation on how to design a dual supply, discrete, programmable gain amplifier circuit. Please visit www.ti.com for additional information and resources.